Some Startling Truth About Addictions, coming up next on Pastor Bob Daily. We've learned a lot from many studies in the last few years about addiction, the nature of addiction, and the cure for addiction. Drug addiction, alcoholism, many different forms of addiction. And, you know, there are many things that we've thought about addiction in the past that are proving not to be true. In the not-so-distant past, we've penalized people for addictions. We've put them in jail. We've put them in programs. We've isolated them from friends and family to supposedly get well. And we only have seen a very small percentage of those people that actually get well. It seems our addiction continues and continues and continues. So what is the truth of addiction? Well, I've been reading studies the last few years, and, you know, there's some amazing studies that have been done about the nature of addiction that shows that we've really probably been thinking about it all wrong. And I want you to consider some things today, because I think all of us have a part to play in the addictions around those people that we love. We're realizing that it isn't so much about addiction as it is bonding. Now stay with me here. You know, our need to escape or to find relief or something that's meaningful is huge. All of us need that. All of us need to connect and to bond with something that will help us cope. And not one of us, seriously, not one of us escapes that. We all need it. It's part of who we are. So, you see, it's not so much about personal recovery as much as it's about social recovery. It's about connecting with people. It's about meaningful relationships. It's about bonding to something else that isn't just for escape, but something that's meaningful in our lives. You know, there was an interesting study done years ago on the soldiers that were in Vietnam, and I remember this, that they were predicting that 20% of our soldiers in Vietnam were addicted to heroin. And we were afraid that when they came back to the United States that we would have hundreds of thousands of junkies on the streets because of their addiction. But the truth is that 95% of them simply just stopped when they got home. 95%. And the difference was that 95% found themselves connecting to something. Connecting to friends, to family. 5% didn't connect so well and continued to find an escape or try to find some kind of relevance in substance abuse. But that should tell us a lot. They just stopped. And folks, what happens when we begin to bond with other people? You see, once again, it's about bonding. It's not about personal recovery. It's more about social recovery. Those of you today that are addicted, those that continue to struggle with addiction, I really believe, personally, that your success and your future is not in how well you can handle a drug. It's about how well you plug in with people, how much you bond with others, how much you can continue to either be selfish and to try to find bonding in other places, or how much you begin to really experience life with other people and the give and take that's all about. And when you begin to bond, and when you begin to have real relationships that really are going somewhere, when you begin to get deep with people, that's when the real healing begins to happen. And I want you to consider this, those of you that are addicted, because this is a huge, huge problem, and it's a big step for you. Will you at least try to bond with people instead of drugs? To realize that you don't have to be addicted, that it's not about addiction, it's about bonding. That's my opinion. I'm not a medical doctor, I'm not a psychologist, but I've seen people that have bonded and it's worked. God bless you. Have a great day.